Valentine, your management tutor on SEC Online Tutorials. Welcome to another wonderful episode of SEC Online Tutorials. In our previous lectures, we talked about leadership and we talked about qualities of an effective leader. Now today, we'll be looking at another interesting aspect of leadership, which is types of leaders. What types of leaders do we have out there? We're going to be exploring their type. We're going to be seeing what they are, who they are, and how they operate. Now, majorly, every leader out there, there are conditions that actually got them into the positions they are, and the way they rule is determined by their words, their personality, and it's also determined by the policies that actually that they met in the firm. So today I have highlighted the five major types of leaders that we have out there. Number one, we have formal leaders. Number two, we have informal leaders. Number three, we have autocratic leaders. Number four, we have democratic leaders. Number five, we have charismatic leaders. Now, you see, a formal leader. Now, a formal leader is, first of all, let me put it this way. Before there could be anyone or any form of leader or any type of leader as a formal leader, there must be a formal setting. A formal setting in what sense? An organization. An organization is practically a formal setting. Or let me look at another formal setting. Let's look at a church. Let's look at a country. Let's look at a state. Let's look at a local government. Let's even look at a class. Are you getting me? A formal setting, what is a formal setting if you are to ask yourself? A formal setting is, you know, a planned setting, a deliberate setting, like, okay, you know, a country is where people live, so therefore there must be a leader to lead them, in order, because where there is no leader, there cannot be rule, and where there is no rule, you know, there is no crime. You know that saying. Now, A school is where you go get your studies, but you know, when you're in the class, definitely you must have a leader in the class, like your class captain. Are you getting me? That will actually be your representative to your teacher. Are you getting me? Then, even to your churches, you must have your pastors. In your mosque, you must have your imams. Now, listen, those settings I mentioned, they are formal setting. And listen, in any formal setting, majority of formal settings that we have out there today, they are bureaucratic in nature. What do I mean bureaucratic? Bureaucratic, meaning that the settings are formed based on policies. There are policies that brought about the settings. So therefore, if the leader is coming into office, the leader definitely must actually rule by that policy. He doesn't have the liberty of using his intuition or his creativity to actually lead his followers. He just have to follow what? The laid down principle, like e.g. the president of our country, Nigeria, President Muhammadu Buhari. He must rule us according to the constitution. There is a constitution he met in the office, so therefore, he cannot do anything outside the constitution. And even if you're a class rep in your school, there will be a code of conduct that, okay, well, this is your responsibility as the class rep, this is what you must do, this is what you must do, this is when you go and call your teacher, this is how you address your teacher, this is how you address your class. Those are policies that are guiding the way you lead your people in the class. In your church, even the pastors, you might not know it. What those policies are known as doctrines. Yes, your members, you should collect what is known as offering from them. You must collect tithe. Imams, you know, there are policies in churches. Those policies are known as doctrines. In a mosque, I don't know what they call it in mosque. Then in a place like country, a state, or a local government, you have constitutions guiding the way the leaders there leads their followers. So you can see in a formal setting is brought about by policies. So therefore, the leader that is being brought in or that is going to rule in that kind of setting must follow the policy. He has little or no right to exercise his intuition, is making decisions or taking actions. He must follow what the policy says, what the constitution says, what rules and regulations of. Even if he is to judge a case, he is going to judge based by the constitution. He can't just come out and no, let's do this way, let's do this way. No, he must follow the laid down policies, the laid down. The only reason why he could actually change from the policy on ground is probably the policy is being reviewed and it is being changed. So that is what a formal leader is. Now let us go to an informal leader. Now, what is an informal leader? An informal leader is the opposite of a formal leader, meaning that it's a leader that is being set out from an informal setting. Are you getting me? And now, based on the fact that it's an informal setting, meaning that there's no policy in place, there is no rule in place, there's no constitution in place to restrict him from using his intuition, to restrict him from using his own ideas in ruling his people. So therefore, he has the power, the authority to actually rule the people the way he seems fit. Are you getting me? So that is why an informal leader is the reverse of a formal leader. A formal leader is based on policy. An informal leader is not restricted by policy. He rules as he deems or as he feels. He's not restricted by any law. He's not restricted by any rule, neither by any constitution. He leads his people the way he feels. He leads his people based on his own intuition, his own ideology, and his own creativity. That's just the difference. That's just an informal leader. Now, let us move to the next one, which is what? An autocratic leader. Now, you see, autocratic leader, they are majorly dictators. What do I mean dictators? Now, an autocratic leader is that kind of leader that, you know, they make decisions on their own without considering their subordinates. They take actions on their own. In fact, majorly decision making is based on their own action or based on their own intuition alone. They don't care about the opinions of their subordinates. They don't care how it affects their subordinates. They just make decision and, you know, pass out the decisions to the subordinate. The subordinates, they don't have any so-called rights to actually question the leader's actions or decision. So, you know, an autocratic is a dictator. They just tell them, this is what I want, this is how I want it. Now, the subordinate don't have an option than just to follow what he has said. Now, that is an autocrat. An autocrat is just, you know, and majorly, I see majority of managers as autocratic. Managers most times are more autocratic as a leader than being, you know, a democratic leader, which we are coming to. Now, you see, meaning that, and the reason why I said manager are more autocratic is because most managers are goal-oriented because they are under pressure to achieve a goal. So because they are under pressure to achieve that goal, they are goal-oriented instead of being human-oriented. So that is an autocratic leader. An autocratic leader makes decision on his own, takes his time, does what he wants to do, subordinates don't question, they follow his orders. That is what an autocratic leader. Now, let us move to the next one, which is what? A democratic leader. Now, a democratic leader is the opposite of what? An autocratic leader. A democratic leader, in what sense, is human-oriented. He likes to hear the opinions of his subordinate. He likes to take ideas of his subordinate or his followers in making decisions. In fact, he brings them together, and you know what? They jointly makes what? A round table decision. Although he gets to say the final say in the meeting, maybe when they come, just tell them this is what's on ground. And you know, he hears what the subordinates have to say about it. He hears their advice. And when he's going to make that his decision, he's going to make his decision based on the contributions of each of his subordinates. And you know, this is the kind of leaders, you know, most our world needs today. But, well, as you know, some of our leaders, they decided to be autocratic. Well, majorly, whether a leader is autocratic or democratic, it depends on their personality. Are you getting me? There are some people, they are a team player. Majorly, autocratic leaders are not team player. They are what is known as a one-man mopo. They do their thing the way they want, and you know, when they want to achieve their goal, they actually go for it. Now, why a democratic leader is actually a team player? He shares his ideas, borrow ideas from his subordinate world to make a better idea that will move the organization forward. And finally, we'll be looking at what a charismatic leader. A charismatic leader is that leader that is based, that is chosen based on a unique quality that the person possesses, e.g., character-wise. Okay, the brother is gentle, he doesn't talk too much, he is time conscious. You know, those are personal qualities that they can see in that person. Oh, he's experienced, he is knowledgeable, he's wise, he's understanding, you know, stuff like that. Especially when it comes to those features in that we mentioned in their last class. Majorly, most leaders are picked by those features because people generally, they possess those features, they practically possess those features as part of their character. And in as much as, like I said in the last class, out of the 8 characteristics of a good or of an effective leader I mentioned in the last class, if he can possess at least 5, then he's a good leader. Now, a charismatic leader can be chosen based on that. You can say, okay, we are looking for someone that is honest, that has integrity, that is bold, that is energetic, that has a good knowledge of human relation. You know, you mention those characteristics and you know, you go on a hunt and you discover this person. Now, when the moment this person is picked based on those characteristics, because the kind of job they want him to come and do there entails those unique features, those unique characteristics. Well, that is how I'm going to end it there today. As you have learned, these are the types of leaders that we have out there and how they work. So, if you like this lecture, please make sure that on our page you subscribe and you click like. And please don't forget to drop a comment or your questions on our page. Thank you. See you next time.